Morning to you. Did you know that 60% of the population worldwide wakes up with a sharper brain every Tuesday in the morning? I just found that out this particular morning. But anyway, it's a brilliant one. Ready on Urban Today. Good morning to you. And good morning to everyone who's joining us for yet another beautiful episode here on Urban Television. My name is Derek Ainedash. And of course, I'm joined with another duo, Dino and Willis Daly. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Derek.
How are you guys doing?
Like you said, my brain is good.
You look sharper than before.
I am sharp. I feel sharp. I don't know what the day has to offer, but right now.
It's a Tuesday.
Right now.
60%.
I'm getting everything on a 2-2-2. It's a 2x2.
Hey, okay. All right, I'm on a 3x3.
You know.
Yeah, 3x3.
Excuse us, rich man. Bless us with your wisdom.
You see,
you the poor.
Us rich people. The Uganda Airlines was tested the other day. But it does not make sense if someone from Bulisa just joins the parliament out of the blue. Tell the Minister of Education that a primary school needs a nursery class. Because there is no way a cow can be with a fly in the same meeting.
Okay.
And you see a chimpanzee jumping from one tree to another, telling us how...
Are we still going to have the kids' story?
Which kids' story?
The mosque and just disconnect
from
people's
brains.
Clearly,
it's usually good to joke some people's brains. But anyway, it's a fantastic morning. It's a Tuesday. If you're planning to go to work, it's a day that you need to take things a little bit easy because the week has just started. You know, you just need to give everything your all, cut out a lot of noise, and, you know, just focus on making a lot of money.
I say that you don't even need to focus. You just need to go into beast mode. This day, like Monday is given. It's a blues Monday. But from Tuesday to the end of the week, beast mode. You're like supposed to be out there.
Is it Tuesday or Tuesday?
Tuesday.
To what?
To what?
Tuesday.
Which schools did you attend again?
Which schools?
Which one?
That's what I had. I had
good schools that you never mentioned.
Very, very good schools.
Are you proud of these very, very good schools?
Very proud of them, just not proud of my OBs and OGs.
No, just mention the schools. It's okay.
I know it is good. I'm fine.
Is any of your OB prominent like me?
They're very prominent, by the way.
Are they rich people like Willis?
Extremely rich, but my problem and concern is...
You know the rich
when they juxtapose Tina in high school with Tina now, they'll be like, Chase, you have come from afar, darling.
Yeah, yeah. You've come from
far. Yeah, you've really
come.
People have struggled to make it in life.
The creative guy who decided to put a catwalk in a forest. I remember that photo.
Wait, what?
Weren't you catwalking in a forest?
I was not. Why not? Not that. Not
you
that
had
walking.
In your 10-year challenge, are those pictures that you took while having cassava, miwogo, uchi,
he's talking about the one where I was in the forest and I was wearing close to nothing.
Can you believe you're a runway model at some point?
Runway?
No.
But you know what's weird, though?
This is forest footpath mondo.
Here's what's annoying, though.
You have
is that as skinny as you've seen those photos, as skinny as I was, I was still considered a plus size model. I swear. Like, I would go.
But anyway, it's not anything is possible.
Like, when
in
I
the
go
60s,
to a casting.
You know? Back in the 60s, anything was possible.
So. I'll go to a casting agent and they'll be like, you won't be with them, but you can be right here. I'm like, wait, what? They're like, you see, you have those ones. Like, it's like they were against hips and a butt and being normal. So I always used to be casted as a plus size. But it's beautiful to find out that plus sizes are getting it now.
So if you were casted as a plus size those days and you were as slim as a toothpick.
I wasn't as slim.
If you were to be casted right now, what would you be casted as?
There's a plus size model, then there's a bogoya.
I can't be doing this on air. I can't be fighting with you on air. But hey, I mean, guys, it's a Tuesday. Wake up. You know, wake up, be in best mode. The week is not going to wait for you. No, it's not going to wait for you to get your head around it. Nah, get up. Do what it is that you're supposed to do. Do not procrastinate. This is the time not to procrastinate. 2019 is the year where we're doing two things. One, we're finding clarity. Two, we're not procrastinating. So believe.
Unless you're Theresa May. If you're Theresa May,
okay, Theresa May, it's okay because. Yes. But some of us have Theresa May tendencies.
If you ask Theresa May, you can.
We have the tendencies.
Someone was asking now, so what's the meaning of procrastination? And she said, at a later date, I will tell you the meaning and possibly. I died.
And on the other hand, let's make sure that we do get to use our brains. And maybe some of you, if we told you that the brain is actually an app, you'll download it and use it.
Yep.
So let us try and, you know, before we put our words there, our thoughts, let us analyze the situation.
And there are many ways to update your brain as an app. There are many ways. You can read the news, news. You can, you can, you know, do those
usually quizzes.
Quizzes, and Facebook has done really a good thing with its messenger. You can play with one or two people. Mm-hmm. So find someone who's
idolized.
It's really fun. It's really fun. And they really ask questions that are simple, memory, and you jog your memory.
Also, another way to, you know, update your brain, just tune into Urban Television every particular morning, Monday to Friday, 6:30 a.m. up to 8 a.m. You will have your brain sharper than even that one of, who's the sharpest guy in Uganda?
Don't go. Katoluwam.
I didn't say sharp in that kind of way.
That's a word, sharp.
Which kind of
way? You said sharp.
We just gave you, I gave you a
okay, Professor Ogenga Latigo.
Mr. Jimmy Akena.
But the sharpest of all, Chigenyi Willis.
Someone slapped this moon pen.
No, I'm sure, you see, let me tell you something. You can deny facts.
I think you can add it to win. Some words in air, some people don't hear them. You say, I didn't say shortest. I said sharpest.
He is sharp.
You can sit here.
You cannot be short.
You can be short and sharp at the same time. Listen,
that is a tall person who is sharp.
Say those words back to back.
You cannot be short and sharp at the same time.
It's like being a short sharp shooter. You can sit here the whole time and add you. By the way, on a salary, you can add you on a salary for a full week that I'm not sharp, and you still come up with the same result.
That you're sharp?
That's your opinion.
That is the most confusing statement you've made
this morning. Can we go in a break? I can't deal with this.
Let's get into some shout-outs this morning. Now, man, of course, I want to begin with congratulating the one and only Honorable Mubarak Munyagwa. Finally, is going to be, of course, replacing Honorable Abdu Katuntu as the new chairperson for COSESE. Now, I cannot wait to see how he handles this post down, of course, at the parliament. Finally, of course, the prayers have been heard. Very many people were against Abdu Katuntu being, chairperson. Now, of course, they have come out to appoint a new personnel right there. We'll wait and see how this journey unfolds for Munyagwa.
All of them come with the same kasigiri, the same charcoal stove.
Kasigiri can
mean. Therefore, me, you're going to see, I am going to show you.
Then later.
You see, Mr. if I can understand you correctly, I am not an economist. But how did the money disappear from Rajendra's office to the governor Bank of Uganda?
Okay, then you go down again. Then after like 3 days.
Then they explain to him for like 2 days. Meanwhile, they take breaks for 2 days, then he comes back. So you see,
I
will be waiting for your reaction.
I want you to treat me like a layman.
Please explain these things.
On the other hand, I'm also sending more shout outs, of course, the government as far as betting in the country is concerned. Now, with effective of 1st March, anyone who is below the age of 25 years of age is not going to be allowed to involve themselves in betting. And more so, before you do actually bet, you need to have your national ID and a passport number. So you either have the national ID or your passport number. And above all, the most interesting rule is that you need to give a source of your money. Where are you getting this money that you're going to involve it? You need to explain why you've gotten that 1K. You need to be above 25 years of age. You need to have a national ID or a passport number.
That means to have now any you can't bet.
No, I think those guys now, listen.
You can't bet.
These guys have been watching Urban today. These are the things we talked about, I think, when the betting conversation came through. And I think that it helps.
It does.
Instead of closing the businesses, everyone wins.
Just have strong regulations.
Because, of course, you can't have, but hold on, the kids have national IDs.
Yeah, but they're not yet 25 years.
I think this one, we shall get into it later. I had a PTA meeting at my kid's school on Sunday. And then they...
Oh, you attended?
I do attend. Okay. All the PTAs. And they gave me the new...
What is PTA?
Parents, Teachers Association.
Yeah, okay.
And they gave us a list of what it means for your child to get an ID. You guys, it's not even funny.
The national ID?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
I hear your parents all have to have, then you're supposed to have the chairman, and the chairman is supposed to send the letter to the DSO, and the DSO is supposed to forward it to so and so, and then you're supposed to come with a birth certificate, and then when you get the birth certificate, both parents are supposed to have passports. I was like, wait! My kid is Ugandan, for crying out loud.
We need to be sure.
Jeez Louise.
We need to be sure. I agree with
anyway,
them. Some parents, you need to be sure.
I think it's absolutely useless for
it is.
Know, such a process. Unless you just
because
want to
this
make
is,
money.
Because let's say if I was to do it for my 3 years.
You know how Uganda, you know how things in Uganda
I know.
On every level.
I think that they should just take registrars to...
To the different schools?
No, not to different schools. To our Muzali, where do they call those things where you give birth?
What, to the maternity ward?
Yeah, to the maternity ward.
And like whenever you pop a baby, they're like, keep it! This is a baby!
So from the place of birth, the place you're going to is probably church for the baptism.
And church? After giving birth, the
you
doctor says
the
your daddy,
the
you live with your national ID, your baptism.
They're not for man at all.
That way.
Anyway. Oh, God. I would like to send my shout outs to none other than Jonah. Mm-hmm. Yes. Now, if bad luck is your amaza, honestly, you deserve all the shout outs that there were or there is. Now, recently, she was taken in to CID for questioning on her bad remarks that she made on the president sometime last year in August. But this is what's funny, though. When she gets to the CID's office, she finds there are two files. File number two, number one is for the president's social media situation. File number two, though, is about her neglecting her child, Jonah. Now, apparently, she was in Kenya and she couldn't pay her hotel bills. So she just abandoned the child there and left and came back and paid after a while. So they opened up that file. I'm like, this poor Jonah has suffered. Like, in this whole struggle, you all need to come together. We need to, like, we need a family gathering to sit down and figure out what we should do for Jonah. Where is Jonah's father?
That's what I was going to ask. Where is Jonah's dad?
Jonah, who's your father, boo-boo? And this, by the way, this shout-out is not just simply to Jonah. This shout-out is to all those kids who have slay cartoons for moms, who just decide to make you a like, a follow. Ah, it's sad. It's sad. These millennials, huh? But wait, is Bat like a millennial? Because she told us she slept with 10,000 men so far. I don't
And those are the ones she remembers.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. There's no one who can ever give you the exact figure. They'll be lying to you.
That's a major body count.
Yeah, a major body count. But
you
of course,
cannot.
Remember there are like 2,000 people that she has forgotten about. So.
Oh, child.
You can never know. How many people have you slept with?
How many?
How many people have you slept with? Why are you going? How many?
In my entire life. Yeah. Does that include my mother?
Ew!
What? Don't you sleep with your sons in the same bed when they are babies?
Are we talking about slept with or?
This is what he asked. How many people have you slept with?
How many people have you had intercourse with?
Which intercourse?
Sexual.
Spiritual or sexual?
Sexual.
Sexual. Depth over shallow.
Shallow.
Shallow. Mm. When we are naked, when we are not.
When you're naked.
When we are naked. Mm. Inside the blanket, outside the blanket.
On top of the blanket.
On top of the blanket. Mm. When the window is open, when it is closed.
It is always open.
When it is open. Mm. Okay. When the curtain is also open, when it
is
not.
No curtains.
There's no curtain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Are you saying that I had sex in a hat?
But a hat doesn't even have windows, does it?
It does. Some do.
Some do.
Have you met the ones in, the guy with the one eye, our own Fetty Wap. Yeah, like you saw his house.
I am not part of that conversation.
And
I
was
nowadays, I'm not joking.
His house looks like a cake.
Now you're trying to sugarcoat it.
No, I'm not sugarcoating it.
You are talking about the
cake.
It looks like a quadrilla.
That's
still sugarcoating.
You're still sugarcoating.
Sadi Amu said that Fetty Wap.
Idiots remind me of Fetty Wap. What, you wanted me to call him?
I didn't want you to call him.
Why are you defending yourself?
You wanted me to call him Fetty Wap.
I didn't want to call him anything.
It is her general.
Yes, it is me. I'm ready to take it.
If you've watched videos of the guy who resurrected as a result of a professor praying for him, then you must also notice that there's a video of the guy actually eating fries, matoke, rice, and stew.
That's my guy
also,
right there.
There's that guy who was the only white man at the funeral when the guy was being risen. And if you look at his face, he's like, what the...
How did I come to this? Like, the look on this guy's face is just so priceless. It's like, I have seen it all, but Africa wins still.
The reason why I'm shouting out to this guy is it's a picture of him and the pastor in a country, probably London or Turkey or somewhere.
Which guy? The white guy?
Yeah, the white guy.
Ooh, so he's an investor?
That's why I call him an investor. I mean, why else would he be here and in the same picture with the pastor?
I actually wanted to talk about something after you guys did this, we looked at this more intricately. And then yesterday someone tagged me on social and there's one particular belt that almost every pastor is wearing. Benny Hinn was wearing it. That pastor was wearing it. Hmm. Like three other night, Bushadi was wearing, what's his name? Buhari? No.
Bushadi.
He was wearing one. I was like, wait, well, what's the neck model? I have screenshots. I'll show you. It's scary. I'm like, what is
the
coincidence?
But also, there's a...
It is the truth.
In other news about the same story, apart from the guy eating, of course, and whatnot.
With his mouth like this.
But who buries someone when their mouth is open?
That's what I want to know. The funeral...
There's also the fact that there's a photo I've seen of the same guy ages ago when he was filming the pastor as he apparently worked on a miracle in a...
Who was filming?
The guy who...
The dead guy. So,
there's also a story that the funeral services, that if you saw the car, the car that brought the
house.
The funeral services of our kings and queens funeral services released a statement and said, guys, for us, we have documents of every dead body. We don't have this one.
Actually, no, in their defense, they say that how they what came to be that they didn't have those documents is that they argued with the family argued with the contracted funeral home. So when the argument ensued and they really wanted to bury, they just contacted these guys and they're like, you know, at Mutuyambe, Kasaidia, let's kumaliza this. So all the paperwork had stayed with the right funeral home. I'm like, that's fishy.
You know, one thing I'm looking forward to, usually such people who are brought back to life, you know, from the dead, they usually never tend to live longer. So I really want to find out how long does this man get to live. There's usually that kind of small bit of days. Oh, they usually have like a week.
Like the other guy who
they have business on,
put your house in
order. But you see, I cannot let go of this story, honestly.
You are
even if it takes a year, but I cannot let go of this story because
you remind me of Money Heist.
Lol.
But on the other hand, if you're interested in learning Chinese, guess what? Urban TV will be hooking you up. Come this 10th of March, we'll be having a show that, of course, will be teaching you about Chinese. We'll be talking Chinese. Let's learn Chinese. Ni hao. Hey, for those of you who want to learn all those. And remember that we'll be giving out gifts every particular episode of the show. Urban Television and, of course, in conjunction with the Chinese government, we'll be giving out some gifts for you. And by the end of the 5 months whereby we'll be teaching you Chinese, we'll give some of the lucky winners a fully paid trip to China. So how about you keep it ready on Urban Television, because we'll be speaking Chinese by the end of just 5 months this 2019. Up next is our weather forecast for those of the temperatures to expect later this day. Welcome back from that. We're now away from that one to get into last night online. Now we take it to social media and we're picking a picture down from Nairobi. Hey, His Excellency Uhuru Kenyatta spotted in traffic jam. As you know, he's cruising through his cross country right there. Now you can imagine having our very own president cruising in his one of you know those impeng on the around Ginger Road.
Wait, do you think our president can drive though?
Yeah, the president has been time and again been jogging around State House. Outside State House.
Not jogging, like driving. Yeah.
Do you think he can drive though?
We've seen him drive Kira EV, the first one. Yeah. You know,
he knows how to drive. But it's just that he's rich. You see, we rich people.
What? So Uhuru is not rich? Are we talking Uhuru about is, the Kenyatta actually, family? Are we talking about the Kenyatta family?
This one is rich. Unless his father's money. But you see.
No. How can I? You cannot. We are talking about the Kenyatta.
To answer your question, Museveni has driven before. And he usually drives, and like I told you,
sometimes
he drives.
He does. You've not seen.
And sometimes
he's randomly on like.
Yes, randomly. By the way, very randomly, and there's a guy, Babira Wa. There's where he has a farm, and apparently everyone in the village knows him personally. Like he has visited them personally.
Our president.
Yes.
I see him doing
like
that.
He goes and they told him.
He does that at his own area in Chirura.
There's another farm that's away from his place. Mm-hmm. And everyone at the village knows him. So he does that. But my thing is the Ugandan... There's a class of Ugandan middle people who have just got excited with power and office. And for some reason, they have one Kalidika with two guys with them.
And they never want to drive looking at this particular photo, Uhuru Kenyatta driving himself along the streets of Nairobi, the last time we had this kind of incident, his car went missing. We all remember that time when Uhuru was driving around and, you know, he decided to park somewhere and have a good time with some of his friends. And the next thing he knew, his car was missing. And somehow, somewhere, it was found in Kampala.
But the thing is, though, you do not mess with Nairobi. When Nairobi come through, you know they're finna fence. And what's the closest place you can fence in East Africa? It's Kampala.
Because we say that Kenyatta hasn't learned his lesson.
No, I think that his security usually just, you know, when security guys, when, for example, a big guy like that decides to drive around the city, that's a lot of money spent on security. That's a lot of resources, a lot of time. So those guys go through a lot. So they usually advise them against that. Mm-hmm. But, you know, a guy likes to have a blast. I mean, you know Uhuru's lifestyle.
I don't want to really think there's a lot of money that is spent.
There's
on
a lot of money,
my
friend.
Because, listen, this could not be an arranged initiative whereby, you know, he communicates
that. It is always arranged.
No, listen. The president of any nation.
There is a possibility of him maybe wanting to do something out of the blue and he decides to sneak out.
The moment the president says that I want to go to Kampala Road. Mm. He doesn't need to tell people he's going.
Yeah.
The moment he says I want to go to Kampala
Security
Road,
is going
security
to
has to clear him. Actually, in developed countries, he has to seek permission from security. So when this happens, probably security tries to teach him a lesson. So they steal the car and show him the consequences of him just randomly. But the guy clearly has a big head. Both
but I like it.
He just likes to be free. He's a free president.
I love this about Uhuru. Yes, we never thought he would actually turn out to be the president that he stand out to be. He's really a people person. He's a Keroro person. His eyes are just life all the time. All the time. I mean, he's litty. All the time. I just then that guy give a speech and you go like, Mr. President, what happened? He's like,
No, he just has issues with
with his eyes.
His eyes.
I'm talking about one day. How do you explain the shaking, though?
The shaking. It's
normal.
It's a disorder.
Stage fright.
It's a disorder, and then there's also stage
fright. I should give him that thing
fright.
We do with when you pierce yourself with like pins just to take away the nervous. Yeah. Okay.
So you're just trying to look for your echoes.
But for me, those people, I can mention names. You find someone in Ministry of Finance.
Finance against the water.
Minister, without a minister without portfolio over someone working in the ministry without portfolio.
But all ministers
Why are they in a rush?
All ministers supposed to
do what?
This is what it is. Everyone in Uganda has a right to muscle.
To what?
To
get a lead car or something. Mm. But it is upon you, the citizen of Uganda, to write and request to police that you need security for this purpose. And that's police true. To ascertain that you actually need it and indeed give it
and
to
you'll
me.
Get one.
It is not a privilege.
No,
it is
I'm not saying that.
Any Ugandan. I'm saying for the ministers.
They are part of the Uganda.
They also apply to the
Uganda. I know, right?
Don't you see something
my worry is not with the number. My thing is that every minister is entitled to a bodyguard.
They are
entitled. We need to sit down and
our money. Protest.
That is what you'd have said.
Our money.
You saying that?
No. There are ministers who don't have actually.
Do you people actually notice that this conversation is actually boring? Me, I've decided to pick mine. I was like, I really don't
because
care.
Because you're poor.
Listen,
you see,
I really don't
because
care.
Because you have issues with what happens within our country.
Why
you just want to look for a bad black?
I like black because she's a pain.
Away from that, we do want to get into the Press Digest this particular morning. I give you a reason as why you need to look out for the new vision. And not forgetting Bukede as well as the Daily Monitor and what is happening on the international scene. Right, some good news coming in, of course, on the front page of the New Vision. They said that Museveni named among world's best presidents. Now, this is coming in from New York University as well as the World Bank experts. Detailed story on page 4. I cannot wait to see how the opposition gives feedback regarding this one. But anyway, get yourself a copy of the New Vision and catch up with that. A road from Mbale to Kenya border takes shape. They do bring you an air view right there, of course, on the front page. You get to catch up with that. And they're talking about Charlie Gonza speaking out to what did happen, of course, on the center road. CID to take up the case. This is, of course, on page 8. Now, looking into more news, they say that Gulu Archdiocese seeks 900 million for Matters Day. Okay, it was a copy of the New Vision and catch up with that. Government set to regulate Uber safe border taxis. What regulations are these? And of course, all that is in today's copy of the New Vision. Reasons as why M7 has been ranked among best presidents in the world. Get yourself a copy and catch up with that as well. The new era is also out here talking about the Chinese in Uganda. Did welcome, of course, the new year. How do they celebrate it? Get yourself a copy of the New Vision and catch up with, of course, some of the new eras regarding with this whole Chinese and the Ugandan relationships partaking in the country. They do bring you another interesting story by our very own Mbarak Mugabo talking about his experience in China, not forgetting the oil and gas journal or pullout that is always out in the New Vision every Tuesday to keep you updated with what is happening in the oil sector. Her vision also still talking about, you know, women and, of course, a couple of issues that they do go through, not forgetting some regional news as well as some sports, both on the local and international scene.
Now you're lying. Let us move.
But you know what Pyeolang means?
Do I look like I do?
Look, this means beautiful.
By the way, it's important to learn Chinese. Because
it's a world takeover.
It's not even a wild takeover.
There's 1 billion of them. You either be with them or against them. And the way I see it, you have to be with them.
Well,
not against them.
Understanding that that's where we usually get most of our products here. It could be another marketplace for even our African commodities. So yeah, we definitely have to learn Chinese in order to improve on our international trade.
That is the most sensible thing you have said I have ever met you in your entire life.
Well, you see, it's
no, I don't see anything. Can you please read the name?
My father invested
the Daily Monitor,
and I'm proud of my school.
I'm not sensible. I'm not proud of my school. It's okay.
My father is watching, by the
way.
So let me thank him.
It's okay.
His money, time, love, because I wouldn't be here.
I cannot with you anymore. I can't.
What is happening in the Daily Monitor?
Anywho, Major General Charlie Gonza speaks out on Brown. Now, he says they made a U-turn after occupants of two vehicles that were involved in an accident in setup created a chaotic scene. And then someone goes like, and you created more chaos. Like, you were running from chaos only to create more chaos. And sad news here. Magara
Is that why they beat up a journalist?
Apparently, we shall get into that later. Magara murder suspect stabbed, beaten. Now, 1 year later, the eight suspects that were arrested after Susan Magara's body was found dumped in Chitiko village on the Entebbe Express Highway on February the 27th of 2018, 3 weeks after she was kidnapped. Now, you need to really read this story. It's getting really, oof, child. Water is life, and of course, we're seeing light at the end of the tunnel as rains do return. How church is going to spend 900 million on Martyrs Day? Now, New Vision had a totally different figure. That's 600 and something?
No, they're talking about 900.
900 too? Wow. 900. Okay, and government to put a ferry on Lake Bunyonyi, looking at sports UNF to spend 140 million on government officials. Now, this is something I need to talk to Nick about. 142 million on government officials. Not that they're going to play, not on the players, not on the league, not on the team, but on government officials who are just going to show up.
But Uganda, we have money. What is happening in Bukede before we run out of time? You made it.
Hey, anyway, the biggest story in Bukede for me, Bagamita, Batembe, Mongere, O Kubakwa, Samani, Bani, Abatembe, Mongere, O Kubakwa, Samani, Bukede, Bayogede, Kosimani, Gurabukendo, my name is Singa, or download the app better still. And you know, you can read this paper in your bed, comfort of your bed. Senga, of course, has come through one of my favorite pullouts in Bukede.
Abanonya
Sivi Sivi, Bakabianyo. Name Valinio Bukede.
Of course, Baba Kolela Christine, no?
No, call Christine. Where's Christine?
You.
That's not my name.
Don't you? Your name is
Chirunji.
I'm Tina.
Chirunji.
Your national ID has the wrong name. Mutina.
Do I have a national ID?
Yeah. When you head to the Guardian, when you get to the Guardian, one of the most favorite international papers that we like to read, a snake on a plane goes 9,300 miles from Australia to Scotland in a woman's shoe.
Jesus.
Wow.
She reached home.
I just got chilled.
She saw the snake, and someone who saw the snake first thought that this snake was actually a toy, sort of a prank. From the guest to her.
I literally just grew
I would like pimples. To get more details regarding that.
No, I grew goose pimples just from that. Good Lord. You know how and that it can become a phobia. Like every time one of my kids wants to wear their shoes, he must go like, because one time he put his foot in and there was the tiny frogs.
But you see, that's how animals migrate. That's how we also migrate as human beings. So
it's
nature.
Right?
It's nature taking its course.
In a shoe.
Yes.
My shoe.
That's how we migrate. That's how
on
you find
I paid for.
Yeah.
To a totally different country.
Yes.
Where customs is not even going.
Whether you want it or not, whether you take us through,
that's how
it is. That is how it is.
Snack, please.
That's
when
it
you
is.
Want to snap on the snack, like.
Urban Today is going in for another quick break, but when we do get back, we want to find out what is on a tea at 7. So do grab that coffee, do grab some warm water for you, and be ready to jump on through this conversation with us right after this short break.